Hello, good morning everybody. In the last tutorial, we made the client create a room. In this one, we are going to make the clients able to join a room created by another client. Let's get started. From now on, I won't show the server when we run the client, but I will have it running in another workspace. When the player presses the create button, he will connect to the server. But what happens if you close the pop-up window? We will still be connected, and if we try to connect again, we will get a bunch of errors. We want to disconnect when the window is closed. For that purpose, let's make a function that stops the connections. Open the client script and add a new function called stop. As always, print some message at the start of the function to see when the function is called. After that, disconnect all the signals. Connected to server, connection failed, and server disconnected. With all the signals disconnected, change the network peer to null to disconnect from the server. Let's call this function in the menu script. We want to call it when the create dialog is closed. So, connect the pop-up hide signal to the script. Remove the part with the node name of the signal name. Later, we will connect the same function of the join dialog and we will use the same signal name. This way, we don't need to create two functions, only one. In the signal function, before calling stop, make sure we are connected comparing the network peer to null. We don't need to stop the client if it has not been connected. If we open and close the dialog a few times, we won't get errors anymore. Let's make the join dialog. Add a window dialog node in the menu scene. I use a window dialog instead of an accept dialog, like the create dialog, because I don't want a confirmation button. Put some title to the window, like waiting for players. Check exclude if you don't want the window to close when you press outside. We will make the client able to choose a room ID to join the room he wants. So, add a VBox container and rename it to Connect VBox container. Make it fill the entire window changing the layout to full rect. Add a label called Error Label. We will use this label to show an error message if the client tries to connect to a non-existent room or the game already started. Hide the label. We will show it if necessary. Add a spin box to enter the room ID. Change the alignment to center if you want to align the number in the center. Finally, add a button to connect. Put connect button as the name and connect in the button text. Now, let's add a list of players and a label with the room ID, as we did with the create dialog. As a child of the join dialog, add a scroll container. Name it wait scroll container and disable the horizontal scrolling, since we are not going to use it. Change the layout to full rect to make it fill all the variable space in the window. Add a VBox container. And inside this container, add a label to display the room ID and another VBox container to show the list of players. We don't want the list of players to be visible until we connect, so hide the scroll container. In the last video, I forgot to put a VBox container as a child of the scroll container in the create dialog. I don't know if you noticed it, but we get a warning because the scroll container expects only one child. Without the VBox container, the label and the player list both appeared one above the other. So, add the VBox container and move the label and the player list inside it. We also need to update the paths of these nodes in the menu script. Add three unready variables. One for the join dialog, another one for his label that displays the room ID, and the last one for the player list. Modify the update room function. If the client is the room creator, update the text of the label in the create dialog, because this is the window he will have open. If it is not the creator, he will have the join window open. So update the text of the label of the join dialog. We will come back later. Now create a script for the join dialog. We will need a bunch of unready variables. Let's declare them all. One for the connect VBox container node, one for his error label, one for the spin box, one for the connect button, one for the white scroll container, and finally, one for the room label. Connect the preset signal of the connect button to the script. Inside the function, disable the button to prevent the player from connecting more than one time. To connect to the server, call the connect to server function of the client. If you remember from the last video, this function has an optional parameter that indicates the room ID. Pass the value in the spin box as the argument. The value in the spin box contains the ID of the room the player wants to join. Here, you will get a warning because the function expects an integer and the value of a spin box is a float. The step of the spin box is 1, so we will never have a decimal value. Let's just ignore the error. Create a new function called connected_ok. We will call this function when we connect successfully to the server. In this function, hide the connect container. We don't need it anymore since we already connected. Enable back the connect button. This way, if you all want to disconnect and connect again, the button will be enabled. Finally, show the wait container. This is the container with the room ID and the list of players. So, when the connection is successfully, we will change the window content to show the room ID and the list of players. Go back to the menu script and call the connected_ok function in the update room function after updating the room label text. Call the function only when the client is not the creator of the room. Otherwise, it's not necessary since we don't have the join window open. Finally, connect the preset signal of the join dialog to the script. When the client clicks the join button, show the join dialog. Let's try it. Open two clients. In the first one, create a room. And in the second one, try to join the created room. As we can see, the join dialog never changes the content. It shows the room ID when it connects. The origin of the problem is in the connected_ok function in the client script. If the client is not the creator, we are not sending our information to the server, and he does not send back the room ID. To fix it, we have to tell the server we want to join a room. So, here, in the connected_ok function, if the client is not the creator of the room, call the joinRoom function. Pass the room variable that contains the ID of the room the client wants to join, and pass the information of the player to. Open the server project and create the joinRoom function. Inside the function, get the ID of the player who called the function using the get3 getRPCSenderID function. Then, call the addPlayerToRoom function. Remember, the first argument is the room ID. The second one is the ID of the player. And the last one is the information of the player. The addPlayerToRoom function will call the updateRoom function of the client who wants to join, and the join dialog will update showing the room ID. Open two clients and try to join a room again. The result is the same. I actually have an error in the server project. Let's see it. Okay, I forgot to put remote in the join room function. That's what happens when you don't put it. We cannot call the function remotely. Try to join a room one last time. It works now. The client wants to join calls the join room function of the server, and in return, the server calls the update room function of the client, updating the join dialog content. That's all for today. In the next tutorial, we will handle the disconnections and maybe start displaying information about the connected players. I hope you liked the video, and see you in the next one.